Morning everyone. Myself, I'm Jethina Reddy. I'll be discussing coordinate systems today. We have three coordinate systems. Basic coordinate system, Cartesian coordinate system. Cylindrical coordinate system. And spherical coordinate system. Today, we will discuss the coordinates of this coordinate system and their range. Coming to Cartesian coordinate system, the coordinates are x, y, and z. It means any point in the Cartesian coordinate system can be given by P of x, y, z. So, if try to analyze what is x, y, and z, z axis, this is y axis, this x axis towards you, where it's facing towards you, try to plot a 3D graph on a 2D board. So, this is x, this is y, this is z. Come to definition for x. X is the perpendicular distance from yz plane, that means as x is pointed towards you. So this is a perpendicular distance from the yz plane. Yz, yz plane. This is yz plane. So if you plot 2, 3, 4, 2 x is equal to 2, which is the distance from this yz plane on the x axis or parallel to x axis. On the x axis or parallel to x axis. Therefore, the range of x is minus infinity to less infinity. As we can have points which has negative value. For example, minus 3, 2, 1. Here x is minus 3. Plotting on the negative side of the x-axis, which is the other side of this board. Exactly. Coming to y. Y range is also same, which is from minus infinity to less infinity. It is the shortest distance or perpendicular distance from the exact plane. From the exact plane. This is x that is pointing towards you. And this is z. So this is exact plane. So if you plot minus 3, 2, 1, 2 will come here, which is the shortest distance from this yz plane. Coming to z, z ranges from minus infinity to less infinity, which is the perpendicular distance from the xy plane. This is the xy plane. So this is x. This is x. And this is y. So z is nothing but this distance. If you plot minus 3, 2, 1, 1 will fall here. This is a perpendicular distance or the shortest distance from the xy plane, which is on the z axis or parallel to z axis. Next is cylindrical coordinate system. It's also called circular coordinate system. Here, the coordinates are rho, phi, and z, where rho is the radius of the cylinder, phi is the azimuthal angle, z is the height of the cylinder. Right plot. You take a cross section of the cylinder. in the cylinder of radius rho. We can say rho is the radius of the cylinder or the radial distance from z axis. The difference is radius is always measured from the origin, whereas the radial distance is measured, can be measured from the axis. So if this is rho, all the parallel lines from here is also rho. So as a radius can be negative, the range of rho will go from 0 to infinity. That is phi, which is termed as the azimuthal angle. Phi is the azimuthal angle that is measured from the x axis to the radius of the cylinder. If this is rho and this circle is coming out of this board, then this is also rho. This is also rho. Then the orientation angle is called the azimuthal angle. It is measured from the x axis to the radius of the cylinder or the rho of the cylinder. So this rho can be here on the x axis itself or here, or it may take one complete circle. As you can see, you can plot points here, and rho can be distance from the origin to any one of this point. So the total orientation angle, that is the azimuthal angle, will be as less as 0, the lower limit, and as good as 2 pi. The lower limit is 0 and the upper limit is 2 pi. And 0 and 2 pi are same, so either we can include 0 or 2 pi. If you include both 0 and 2 pi, it runs from 0 to 0, that means pi is 0, which is not valid. So I try to include 0 and exclude 2 pi. Next is z, that runs from 0 to infinity, where z here is the height of the cylinder. Z here is the height of the cylinder, which runs from minus infinity to plus infinity. As you know, the height can't be negative, but negative is only a reference value. If you take origin at the center of the cylinder now, for example, the height is 8 meters, then the z value is 8. The origin is here. If the origin is at this center of the cylinder, then it runs from minus 4 to plus 4. So z can have negative values. So it runs from minus infinity to plus infinity. Now if you take a cylinder, for any cylinder, what is constant for a cylinder? For a cylinder, rho is constant. Whereas if you take a circle in a cylinder, if you circle in a cylinder, then you can see the demonstration for that. I try to take a circle, I try to integrate these circles, I'm trying to place different colors of circles here. When I try to integrate these circles all together, we get a cylinder. We get a cylinder. Then if you can see the top view of this cylinder, it shows you only one circle. So for this cylinder, the circle of radius rho, this is circle of radius rho, therefore for a cylinder, rho is constant or radius is constant. Now if I choose you to pick any one of the colored circle, you try to pick any one of the colored circle, for example you have picked this white circle here, then for this circle here at this position, rho is constant, as well as this circle has a position, that is the height from the origin, that is z. Therefore for any circle we have rho and z are constants. Now coming to a coin, now everyone had chosen one circle here. Previously I told you to choose a circle. Now in that circle, you try to choose a point. Example, I choose a white circle. So in this white circle, now I'll choose a point. I'll choose any one point here on this circle. So that means at this point, radius rho is constant. Already the position is there, z is constant. As well as this particular point will make an angle with the x axis. Therefore, phi is also constant. So for a point, you can say rho, phi, z are constants. Therefore, for any coordinate system, every point is unique, we should be given by P of rho gamma phi gamma z, because for any point, for any given point, rho phi z are constants. Coming to the third coordinate system, the spherical coordinate system, the coordinates are r, theta and phi, where r is the radius of this sphere, theta is the coordinate angle, phi is the azimuthal angle. So, as you know, r is the radius of the sphere, radius can be limited. It runs from 0 to infinity. Try to take a sphere now. Trying to draw a sphere of radius r. Radius is nothing but the distance from the origin to the surface of the sphere, so which is r. Sphere can be as small as 0, 0, sphere of 0 radius is nothing but a point, and it can be as big as infinity. Therefore, the value of r runs from 0 to infinity. Next is theta. Theta is called a co-altitude angle. We can say theta, we can define as theta is the angle of the cone. Theta is nothing but the angle of the cone with its vertex at the center of the sphere. Now, you can see this projection. If you try to place this cone over here, this angle that I draw is theta. That means you can take a sphere or a ball like structure and you can cut a circle here. So each circle will make a projection which is nothing but the angle of the cone, which is theta. Now, someone from you may take a small circle. And I may take a point, that if I take a point, then this angle will be as small as 0, so therefore the lower limit is 0. Whereas the upper limit, I am trying to increase this cone, radius of this cone. At a max, I can increase up to a semi-sphere, which has, now the angle of the cone now will become pi. Therefore the upper limit is pi. Coming to phi, phi is nothing but the azimuthal angle here, which is running from 0 to 2 pi. Now, if you see any two coordinate systems, your x, y, z, z runs from minus infinity to plus infinity here, and we move from one coordinate system to another coordinate system, only two coordinates are changing. Here x, y, z, here rho, phi, z, z is common. When the coordinate is common, its meaning may be different. Here z is the perpendicular distance of the x, y axis, whereas here z is the height of the cylinder, but the range is same. Range would not change from one coordinate system to another coordinate system. Here also we have rho phi z, here we have r theta phi. Phi is common, then phi is the azimuthal angle here. It is the angle from the x axis to the radius of the cylinder. Whereas here, phi is different. Phi is here the orientation angle or the orientation of the point or the circle. No matter, as you choose a circle now, each circle will have a projection. So I took my circle, which has my projection, thus. Now if I try to take a point on this circle, then this point will make some orientation with the x-axis. Now if you see from this top view, you can have the x-axis coming out of this circle. So if I take a point here on the x-axis, it is 0. If I take it here, it is 10 degrees. Here it is 20, here it is 90, here it is 180, here it is 270. That means, here, the orientation angle of this point will have again 360 degrees. That is, pi from 0 to 2 pi, it is 0 when it is on x-axis, and it is 2 pi when it takes one complete circle. So either you include 0 or 2 pi. Either you can include 0 or 2 pi. So these are the three coordinate systems, namely Cartesian, cylindrical and spherical coordinate system, and their coordinates as well as their range. Thank you. Hopefully this particular session is useful for you.